Welcome to the November edition of PierceTV. I'm Joshua.
And I'm Marisa.
This month we'll have clips from the upcoming fall play, The Nerd, as well as information from TRIO and our student success programs here at Pierce College.
We'll also highlight some work from our students in the digital design and film programs and have some clips from the computer labs and fall athletics.
Our first segment is about John Simpson, a history instructor here at Pierce College who has been an embedded photographer with our troops in Iraq.
John's recent presentation in October from Baghdad to Mosul highlighted his outstanding photographic work.
John Simpson teaches history and photojournalism here at Pierce College. He also writes and takes photos for a Lakewood newspaper called the Fort Lewis Ranger, a paper that focuses on soldiers and events at nearby Fort Lewis. In the fall of 2004, John took his local journalism to a new level as he followed a Fort Lewis striker brigade to Iraq to cover a small part of their combat tour. He since used his experiences there in his classes here at Pierce College.
I teach two civilizations classes. They come in nicely there. At times during discussions in my American history classes, those experiences are a good sounding board, a good experience to draw off of. And at points when we start to talk about the political and military reasons as to why we are in Iraq, that experience I use in my Vietnam War history class. I teach five classes here at the college, and so I have found that my Iraqi experience has been put to use in varying degrees in all five classes.
Ben Hollander was a student in that Vietnam history class.
Some of his points, I think, especially with the Vietnam War, we watched some videos that was taken in that, and most of them, you see a lot of people when they think of war, think of the violence and the graphic images and stuff like that, which is true, that it is a big part of war, but there's also a softer side, which we saw some of those images in the Vietnam class, and then when Mr. Simpson brought his pictures in, he showed a lot of the pictures of the Iraqi people interacting with the soldiers. He showed a lot of the better side and stuff that the media doesn't necessarily get to see these days and age. Same thing with Vietnam, you know, there's so much negative media in the Vietnam era that I think when Mr. Simpson brought this in, you know, he's just kind of showing the good, the aspect that the soldiers that are doing over there and what they're trying to accomplish. So.
Focusing on the positive aspects of what Fort Lewis soldiers were doing in Iraq also helped John learn about the Iraqi people and culture. Knowledge he is now passing on to his students here at Pierce College.
One of the things that we teach here at Pierce College is multiculturalism. And having had the experience of working in Iraq with American soldiers amongst Iraqi citizens, that experience gave me an appreciation for a culture other than my own. It also allowed me to experience firsthand an Islamic culture. And these experiences are something that I incorporate on a daily basis into my lectures.
This fall, John will be adding new material to his course lectures as he heads to Iraq for the second time. He'll once again embed with a striker brigade from Fort Lewis. This time, though, he plans to do things a bit differently.
Trying to take better photographs, trying to write better stories. The focus remains the same, telling the story of the soldiers involved in Iraq, showing basically the good that they do.
Here's more 3D animations from students in the Pierce College Digital Design program.
Thank you.
Jimi Hendrix.
Stand up for your country and your beliefs and start singing. Track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the Crystal Fountain. So come with me, we'll go and see the Big Rock Kandee Mountains. In the Big Rock Kandee Mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes, and you sleep out every night. Where the boxcars all are empty, and the sun shines every day. On the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings."
One important thing to remember as a student at Pierce is that there is a large number of resources available on that journey through college.
Here from our TRIO program is Terry Green, and from our advising center is Monica Nucciarone.
Are you thinking of transferring to a four-year school? Are you looking at getting your AA degree at Pierce College? Did you know that not all two-year associate degrees transfer to four-year schools? Would you like additional assistance figuring out how to transfer, how to fill out admissions forms, financial aid forms, scholarship forms, and maybe what classes I really need to take so that my transfer process is as pain-free as it can be? Well, the TRIO program at Pierce College may be for you. TRIO is a federally funded grant from the U.S. Department of Education. There are almost 3,000 TRIO programs across the U.S., and they have been helping students since the 1960s. And oh yes, Oprah is the most famous TRIO participant. To qualify, you must be attending the Fort Steilacoom campus in Lakewood. You need to be one of the following: first generation, or low income, or have a documented disability. Many students are first generation, meaning that neither of their parents have completed a bachelor's degree. These students benefit from TRIO with our additional guidance on how the transfer process works. Another qualification you must have is an academic need, like placing in a below college level math or English class. We teach a free math refresher course to prepare you for your math class, or so you may retest the College Compass test. We offer structured ongoing support. TRIO students enrolled in our program will receive extensive advising 3 times a quarter. We will create an individualized plan for success that includes course sequencing, transfer planning, career exploration, and personal development. We also offer peer mentoring, mid-quarter progress reports, cultural and family activities, including a year-end recognition event. Through TRIO, our students get connected to college resources, including student activities, student government, clubs, multicultural leadership, and several other campus opportunities. We even have grant aid to award to students who have an unmet financial need. When you join TRIO, you may be able to take our free 5-credit college success class called Education 111. This class has many topics, including study skills, time and money management, and 4-year college tours. So when you decide to attend Pierce College in Lakewood, please stop by the TRIO office to see us for an application. We can only serve 160 students at a time, so come by your first quarter. Hope to see you soon.
Pierce College Fort Silicon offers a variety of workshops throughout each quarter that contribute towards a student's success in college. Most appropriately named the Student Success Series, these workshops are scheduled nearly every Wednesday at noon at various locations on campus. Some of these workshops cover topics such as how to apply for scholarships, overcoming math anxiety, note-taking tips, transferring to four-year colleges, exploring career options, and developing a career portfolio. Oftentimes, faculty will grant extra credit for attending these workshops, so check with your instructors to see if that is possible. Whether you gain extra credit or not, these student success workshops will allow you the opportunity to listen to helpful information that will assist you on your journey through college. You are not alone. Juggling personal responsibilities and college requirements happens to everyone who wants to improve their lives through education. Student success workshops offer the kind of help to get you through the nitty-gritty aspects of achieving your goals. Come join us for an hour a week if you have the time, or choose a workshop that strikes a chord with the type of information you specifically need to help you on your journey through college. Student success brochures are available in the Advising Center. Pick up one today.
You're watching Pierce TV, a production of the Digital Design Program at Pierce College.
Here's a promo for this year's fall play, The Nerd, which will be opening in early November at the Fort Silicon campus.
Pierce College Theater presents The Nerd in the Pierce College Theater, November 10th, 11th, 17th, and 18th at 7 p.m. and November 15th and 16th at 10 a.m.
Tell us who you are and what character you're playing, a little bit about your character.
Hi, I'm Tom, and I'm playing Willem. Willem is the hero of this play, you could say, but he just needs a little traction in his life. And it's a challenging part, but I think it's a part that a lot of people will be able to connect with.
And I'm Blake York. I play Rick Stedman, and a little bit about his character. He's the nerd.
And I'm Katie Wheeler, and I will be playing Tansy McGinnis. And she's a cool woman. She wants to be a news anchor in Washington, D.C., and Willem, the protagonist, is her boyfriend, and it's a little bit Tansy.
Hi, I'm Marisa. I'm going to play Maria Black, and it's a really fun part, because I have to run around and do some karate parts.
I'm Carmen Cortazar. I play the part of Clelia Waldgrave. Clelia is a school teacher who acts like she's got the perfect life and turns out that she's got problems.
Hi, I'm Steve Kasowitz, and I play the part of Warnock Walgrave, and he prefers to be called Tiki. He's a real estate tycoon who has hired Willem to do some architect work for him, and Rick proceeds to screw that up, and the comedy ensues after that.
My name is Wesley Wolford. I play Axel. Not to give away too much, but he is the glue that holds together the play.
Is there anything that you would say about the show without telling too much about it? Maybe the rehearsal process, or anything that you've really enjoyed, or why you like doing the show?
The cast is great. We've got a lot of good people, talented, devoted, always here. That's always good.
Your jokes come fast and furious in the show, and you really have to pay attention. Yes. And I think that's one of the biggest challenges of doing the show is the timing of it, getting the timing down with the jokes.
Tell Daddy what's bothering.
A watch? Now, Pumpkin, you know I will put up with a lot, but I will not put up with a liar.
Excuse me.
Ah! I'm sure it was very sweet. You think?
Of course it was.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I mean, what the heck? She was only about 8 or something.
And how old were you?
30.
Oh!
But that really makes me feel better that you thought it was so sweet. You know, her parents didn't think it was sweet, but they wouldn't have put me in jail.
Oh, well.
But no, that really makes me feel better.
Pierce College Theater presents The Nerd in the Pierce College Theater, November 10th, 11th, 17th, and 18th at 7 p.m. and November 15th and 16th at 10 a.m. General admission is $7. Student tickets are $2.
Students at both campuses have access to excellent computer resources.
Here are segments by Tim Nalder from Fort Steilacoom Multimedia Center and by Kandee Nelson from the Puyallup Campus Computing Center.
Walking out of the door, I'm on my way. Can you tell me just where I'm going? Occupational skills, would you give me a clue? What to do, cause my mind's in motion. Just trying to relax, to find myself on the couch with big plans, but there's always tomorrow. Is something wrong with me? Or the way I'm taking? Come on, come on, and tell me why you're staring. Come on, come on, it must be what I'm wearing. Come on, come on, and tell me why is it taking so long for you to recognize and stop? Another day in the sun, I'm having fun. Feel the heat sneaking up on me. I take a look at the sky, a plane goes by. Is that the reason that I can't breathe? I take a look and I wonder why. Why these birds don't fly. It's hard for me to see and I believe. I'm out of my.
Hi, I'm Craig Harris, and I'll be your host and tour guide for this journey into the computer center.
After being academically successful, graduating, and looking back, I can attest that the whole ordeal was a positive experience. And all of this was made possible by the helpful staff, the compassionate faculty, and the concerned administration of this great institution. However, I never would have survived without the technology of the Computer Center and the support of its staff. And after all, that's what this whole program is about. Now the Computer Center is housed mainly in one large space with room for 78 users. There's room for growth. That's not what is most exceptional about the Computer Center.
It's the people and the philosophy. Let's step inside and see if we can find out what makes this place tick.
I'm Holly. Welcome to the Computer Center. How can I help you today?
Hi, Holly. My name is Craig Harris. I believe I have an appointment with Laura Bagley today.
Okay, yeah. I think she's waiting on you. Come on right this way.
Okay.
Craig, how are you doing? What's up?
Well, I have got a few questions I'd like to ask, Laura.
Okay, come on in the office.
All right. Laura, I was wondering if you could explain to our viewers a little about what the Computer Center is all about.
I'd be glad to, Craig. We really see ourselves as a support system for the entire college. We serve students, staff, and faculty, but our most important product is student success.
I think our mission statement says it all. The Puyallup Computer Center provides timely, caring, quality service to the students, staff, and faculty of the Pierce College District.
Would you mind sharing with us a little bit more how you implement the service you mentioned in your mission statement?
Well, Craig, it starts with our first point of contact, our student lab assistants. Now let me ask you something.
Okay.
How were you treated when you first stepped into the Computer Center?
Well, I was met by a very friendly face, and she did seem pretty confident and knowledgeable about it. So, yes, I was treated very, very well.
So how did that make you feel?
Well, Laura, I felt welcomed and important, and I really felt like she listened to my needs.
Good, Craig. That's exactly what we're aiming for.
I see. Now, is that something you teach each and every lab assistant?
We begin looking for that helpful, caring attitude in all our lab users, and then we invite those people to come and apply for work here. This year we had over 30 applicants, and we hired the top 10, and then they went through an intense two-day training. The focus is always on the students' needs, and our training consists of teaching them about excellent customer service, not just good customer service.
I see. It certainly appears that customer service a very vital part of what you're teaching.
That's right.
Kandee, could you share with me a few more details about the customer service that you provide here?
We like to call it Knock Your Socks Off service, like the title of the popular book. We also empower our student lab assistants to do whatever is necessary to not only meet the students' expectations, but to exceed them.
Wow, that's a tall order.
Speaking of how the center functions, what can you share with us about that?
I think Marshall, our part-time staff member, can shed some light on that.
We try to give all the student lab assistants all the tools and resources that they need.
We have a fast-track system for tracking student use of the center. I've revamped the entire program, which should make their job a lot easier. Plus, I've added a few improvements.
Well, thank you all for sharing the inner workings of the computer center. I really enjoyed myself. I appreciate all your efforts.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Well, there you have it. I hope you folks have found this journey to the center both informative and inspiring. I'm Craig Harris, and thanks for watching.
If you're on the Fort Steilacoom campus in November, make sure to stop by the art gallery in the Olympic building. Featured this month is the Pierce College Faculty Show, including drawings by Paul Clinton and photographs by David Johnson.
You're watching Pierce TV, a production of the Digital Design Program at Pierce College.
This year's Raiders volleyball has had one of its best seasons in recent years.
Here are some highlights from Raiders soccer and Raiders volleyball from this year's season.
Today with a music video made by Scott Perry, one of the students in the digital film program here at Pierce.
Thanks for watching, and we'll be back in December with another episode of Pierce TV.